How do I fix a CRC error when I try to copy a file? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. Outlook started acting up, so as part of my attempts to fix it, I tried to copy the PST to another location. The copy failed partway through with a cyclic redundancy check error. How can I get past this and back up my data? This is a specific example of a fairly general problem. It can happen basically on any disk, copying any file, or even writing a file. The issue is that there is likely to be a bad spot on the hard disk, and the hardware is having problems either reading from or writing to that particular place. CRC error is the message that you get. Now, a CRC error is essentially a fancy name for some fancy math that's used to verify the integrity of data that has been written to media like a hard disk. In a sense, it's a formula that all the data gets piled into, a number gets calculated, and then that number is also included with the data on the media. Then, later, when that data is read, the data is read, that same formula is used to calculate that same number, and if the number turns out to be different than what was accompanying the data, we know that something about the data has changed. In this case, it's probably because the system was either having trouble writing to it or reading from it. The question is, then, if it could be either read or write, well, is it the file that reported it? Is it actually have a bad sector or CRC error? Or is the CRC error a result of wherever we were trying to write the file to? The easiest way to figure this out is to copy the file to nowhere. That sounds kind of silly, actually, but it's very useful because what that does is it reads the entire file and nothing else. That means that the activity accessing the disk only reads the file, and you won't get any errors from the write side of things because there isn't one. The easiest way to do this is to go into the command prompt, change directories to the directory wherever the file you're looking at happens to be. In the case of, for example, my PST, it would be I'd cd, which is the change directory command, to /user/lnote/document/outlook files, and there I would find the file outlook.pst. Your file location, your file name may very well differ based on exactly what it is you're experiencing, but that's the idea. Then copy space outlook.pst, in my case, space null, N-U-L. N-U-L is a special device built into the command prompt, it's actually built into Windows, that is nothing. So what we've just instructed it to do is to copy the file to nothing. It will read the entire file, do nothing with it. But if during that read we get the CRC error, then we know that the CRC error, the bad sector we're dealing with, is actually within the file. If we don't, then we know that the problem is elsewhere. It's to wherever we were trying to write the file. That's actually good information because that means you can back up the file, copy the file somewhere else. You can do something to resolve the error with the disk. Now, we'll talk about resolving the error with the disk itself in a moment. But first, let's assume that the file itself is showing the error. In other words, when you do the copy to nowhere, then it shows the error as being within the file. The first thing I would have you do in a case like that is copy the file somewhere else. And I mean literally on a different hard disk or a USB stick or just anywhere else, even though that copy might contain errors. For that to happen, we actually end up using a command line tool, a different one. We'll be using xcopy with the /c option to then copy that file to a different location. That /c means if there's an error, keep copying, keep trying. The default action for both the copy command, the xcopy command, copying within Windows is to stop as soon as there's an error. We don't want that. We want it to keep copying so that we get, it's not a perfect copy of the file, right? It will have errors, But it's a copy that, no matter what happens next, will at least have that to fall back on. It's never going to get any worse than that. With that copy squirreled away, saved somewhere safe, now we start trying to look at fixing things. Now, regardless of whether or not the problem was with the file or with the destination, whichever side of that happened, then we want to see if we can fix the disk, the actual bad sector that we found. Now, for magnetic hard disks, there is a tool called SpinWrite. The problem with SpinWrite is that it's very old, it hasn't been updated in quite some time, and it may not work on all systems. The issue here is that what it does is it actually goes through, it can spend a lot of time essentially refreshing and repairing the media without destroying data. In other words, it will basically refresh everything on the hard disk, including the bad sectors, and it can spend an awful lot of time trying to recover the data from a bad sector before it gives up. But it can do so, and it will, if it's at all possible, it will actually repair the disk and make it usable once again. The other solution, if this doesn't work, if SpinWrite won't work for you, is to run CHKDSK/R. CHKDSK/R is essentially the Windows built-in tool. It does some of the same kinds of things, but not nearly as aggressively and not nearly as completely. But it does offer the opportunity to at least identify bad sectors and potentially move them out of the way. Now, I have to point out that both of these tools, CHKDSK/R, when you know you've got a hard disk problem, and SpinWrite, aren't without risk. They can make things worse. I'm assuming that before any of this, you've backed up. You've got a good backup of your system. But if you're trying to repair a CRC error on a hard disk, those are the two approaches that, honestly, they're the most pragmatic. In some extreme cases, you can go more deeply with hard disk recovery services, but that tends to get really, really expensive, really, really quick. Now, if those two fail, then you're kind of out of luck. You've got your no worse than copy of your file. And now, if, and I have to say if, there are tools designed for that specific file type that you might want to apply, now's the time to bring them out. Since this question was originally about a PST, the tool would be ScanPST that comes with Microsoft Office. That will scan a PST and look for the inconsistencies that are going to result from a bad sector and do its best to try to repair them. I can almost guarantee you that there will be some data loss, potentially a lot. But that's the side effect. That's the downside of not being able to repair the hard disk, is now we have to bring domain-specific tools to try and repair whatever kind of a file you happen to have. And if those tools don't exist, then you really are out of luck. You have to do the best you can with whatever tools you have and with whatever file you have in whatever state it happens to be. Now, it wouldn't be Ask Leo if I didn't tell you how you could have avoided all of this completely by backing up. The issue here is that if you're looking at data loss because of a bad sector on your hard disk, anything significant, like anything more than a day's worth of data loss, you haven't been backing up. Because the simplest solution of all of the solutions is not to do any of the things that I've just described, but instead restore that file from its most recent backup. That way you know the file has not been compromised, the file is in good shape, and at worst you've only lost whatever happened, quote unquote, today or since that time the backup was taken. So use this as another argument for making sure you're doing regular automated backups, ideally once a day, maybe even more. But without those, these are the kinds of things you're looking at, and you are looking at the potential for data loss. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/2935. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.